Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at Linux Mint 21.2 and Ubuntu 23.10. And I'm just showing the installation here so you can see the difference between the two. I'll see you guys after the installation on the first login. All right, we've just logged into both. We're welcomed with the welcome app on the Linux Mint side. On the Ubuntu side, we've got the help improve Ubuntu screen, and it's wanting location services. And then it looks like we're finished there. It's got a software updater that's prompted us. So let's get Linux Mint up and ready. Go to the update manager, apply this update manager update, and basically what I want to do now is get the updates installed, and I'll speed the video up. All right, and now we're going to do a restart test, do a speed test here. And it does look like Ubuntu restarted slightly faster. And here we take a look at the driver manager app for each in Ubuntu, how it looks, and then on Linux Mint. If you had an NVIDIA GPU, this is where that driver version would pop up, and you'd be able to select the different versions. And here we'll take a look at what our resources are doing via the System Monitor application. And it does look like our CPU is less on the Ubuntu side. And memory is about the same. And here we'll do an HTOP comparison. And it does look like we need to install that on both. Luckily, it does give us the command, so we'll just copy that, paste it in, put in our password, and do the same thing on the Ubuntu side. On Ubuntu, it's going to use the snap package. And that's a main difference between these two. Linux Mint uses the Debian packages as well as Flatpaks pre-installed, to where on the Ubuntu side, you're going to get the snap packages by default. So we'll just run HTOP. And memory looks to be about the same on both. And we'll take a look at the file manager for both. In Linux Mint, we've got Nemo 5.8.5. And in Ubuntu, since it's using the GNOME environment, it's got files version 45.rc. And now we'll take a look at system settings. So scroll to the bottom under settings, and there's a system details dialog. And then in Linux Mint, system settings, and then you'll scroll to the bottom of that, and it's system info. And here we do see that the kernel is 5.15 for Linux Mint, to where Ubuntu is on 6.5. Also, Ubuntu uses the Wayland compositor, to where Linux Mint is on X11 still. We do expect Linux Mint to get Wayland support either in 21.3 or the next major release, version 22. And we'll take a look at Firefox. You just go to Help About, and we notice on the Ubuntu side, it's using the Snappack version. And on the Linux Mint side, it's using a system package version that is specifically designed for Linux Mint. Okay, and let's take a look at the software centers for each. Ubuntu's App Center is brand new and is built using Flutter. Flutter is an open source framework by Google. It does look really nice. And during the install, I believe the installation is also built on Flutter now for 23.10. But what I've done is I've pulled up the same application, and we can just see what it looks like in each software center. They both do have a gallery and a description. All right, and we'll take a look at the different system trays for each. So up in the top bar for Ubuntu, we've got our time and then any notifications, our calendar. Over to the right, we've got our power, lock screen, settings, and taking a screenshot, and then our volume rocker, network connection. If you had a wireless card, it would show your SSID in this menu. If you want to enable Bluetooth or disable it, currently it's disabled. It would be orange if I enabled it. Power modes, balanced, nightlight, and dark or light. If I click on the time, it's going to show the calendar and any events I might have. And then I can go into the date and time options. And then here's our volume, network connection, system updates, system reports, which I think this is asking me for language packs and setting a snapshot maybe. Yeah, so we can ignore that. And then any Bluetooth connections we may have. And if we pull up the terminal for both, and run a NeoFetch. Okay, we gotta download it on the Ubuntu side. That's okay, it gives us the command to run. So we'll just do sudo apt install NeoFetch, put in our password, confirm, and then once this downloads, we'll run it. All right, and the big difference here is the kernel, right? Ubuntu is using 6.5, to where Linux Mint is 5.15. These are pros and cons. Being on kernel 6.5, you're going to be able to support a lot newer hardware, to where kernel 5.15 is going to be rock solid. You're not going to have to worry about things crashing on you as much. If we look at the memory, we're a little over a gig, to where Linux Mint is 860 megabytes. So about 200 megabytes less on the Linux Mint side. Version numbers of Ubuntu are year.month, which matches 23.10, as it was released on October 12th, 2023. Ubuntu follows a 6-month development cycle for these interim releases. This means that a new version of Ubuntu is released every 6 months. However, Ubuntu 23.10 is not a long-term support version. It's geared more towards people who just want the latest and greatest of what Ubuntu has to offer. Interim releases like Ubuntu 23.10 are supported for 9 months. LTS or long-term support releases are published every 2 years in April. LTS releases are the enterprise-grade releases of Ubuntu and are used the most. An estimated 95% of all Ubuntu installations are LTS releases, and that's according to their website. With Linux Mint, we get a major LTS release, such as version 20. Then the team releases what is called point releases. So if we look into the graph, we can see major release 20 landed in June of 2020. Then we have a point release 20.1 in January of 2021. Then in July of 2021, we receive another point release of 20.2, followed by the final point release of 20.3 in January of 2022. Hopefully, with version 21.3, that will land around Christmas time. All right, now let's look at extensions. With Linux Mint, the extensions app is just included. I didn't have to download anything special. The application is just there. On the Ubuntu side, I had to go get Extension Manager, and it's the Flatpak version. There is an extension app that's green, but you want the Extension Manager app that's blue. And if we go to Browse, that's what that looks like. The Extension Manager is for GNOME desktop environment, so there are tons and tons of different extensions. And we'll take a look at wallpapers. I really like the color scheme in Ubuntu 23.10. I like that purple. And then Linux Mint, got the classic green. I think that looks good. Here are some different aspects between Linux Mint and Ubuntu to think about. Linux Mint is known for its user-friendly interface, which is similar to Windows. It's often recommended for users transitioning from Windows. Ubuntu, on the other hand, has more of a macOS feel with its dock-like panel and Show Apps launcher. Both are highly customizable. Like I said, the extension manager within the GNOME application has a vast library of extensions that can be used to tweak your desktop to your liking. Both Linux Mint and Ubuntu are considered secure operating systems. Linux Mint 21.2 is based on Ubuntu 2204 LTS and the Linux kernel 5.15, offering a stable and reliable operating system. Ubuntu 23.10, being a newer version, would also be expected to offer stability and reliability while also supporting newer hardware. Both Linux Mint and Ubuntu have strong community support and software packages. Linux Mint 21.2 uses the Cinnamon desktop environment. Ubuntu 23.10 uses the GNOME desktop environment. The choice between Linux Mint and Ubuntu often comes down to the personal preference and the specific needs of the user. Both are excellent choices for a Linux distribution. That's going to do it for today's video. I hope you found it informative and helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.